My name is Denice Townsend. I'm the manager of cardiopulmonary services here at Logan Sport Memorial Hospital. I have been with the hospital 16 years, manager of cardiopulmonary services 8 years. That entails cardiopulmonary rehab, cardiovascular stress lab, echocardio lab, pulmonary function lab, the sleep center, and on the inpatient side, the respiratory therapist. So, the most common illnesses we see as far as we're talking about disease processes, it's COPD, chronic bronchitis, emphysema, asthma are probably the top ones. As far as illness, we see pneumonia and bronchitis with our senior patients. Well, as we age, our muscles get weaker. So the muscles that used to expand in our lungs as we breathe in and out, they get weaker and our airways get smaller, so it makes it harder for us to breathe. Not necessarily. It depends on if they have COPD or they had asthma diagnosed as a child. It just depends on if they followed the protocols that were given to them. Like, did they take all their medications? Did they do their breathing treatments? Did they stay away from things that triggered their asthma? Or did they just live an unhealthy lifestyle? So it really just depends on the person and their lifestyle. Well, when it's hot and humid, it makes it hard to breathe because the air is thicker. And if you have something like COPD, your lungs aren't working well enough anyway. So that humidity makes it harder to breathe. So if it's cold out, it's basically the same thing. The air is a lot thinner, it's colder. So you want to, it's the adjustment of temperatures. So you want to adapt to those temperatures. So if it's hot and you go into air conditioning, you want to put a sweater on. If it's cold and you have to go outside, you want to put a mask or a scarf over your mouth so you're warming that air up. Well, it can be a combination of seeing their primary care provider or seeing a pulmonologist if they have breathing issues and have a pulmonologist, or it could be if they have an ENT doctor to see. It just depends. But usually we tell patients to see their primary care provider first. And that's really their first line, because it may be just a simple infection that they need some prednisone or antibiotics for. If you have a chronic disease like COPD, asthma, chronic bronchitis, emphysema, the best line of service is, best service line we have is the cardiopulmonary rehab. So we have pulmonary rehab that meets on Tuesdays and Thursdays, but certainly patients come in do Wednesday or Friday because we have cardiac rehab on those days. And that is really a great service because it helps to build muscles so you breathe better. They also do education with the patients on weight loss, smoking cessation, breathing techniques. So when they get really short of breath, they're doing some good breathing techniques to kind of catch up their breath so they're not feeling short of breath. The staff does a really good job of working with the patients and getting them built back up to where they have a really good quality of life. If they just have a simple infection, the doctor may order a nebulizer treat for them or an MDI, and the floor therapist on the inpatient side will come and instruct them on how to use those items.